Trust your first impression. What do you see around you?
A forest.
A forest. Mm-hmm. Tell me more. What kind of forest is this?
Trees all with their branches all gnarled.
Mm-hmm. The branches are gnarled. Uh-huh.
Leaves are very green and moist, and kind of like wax-like.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of vines.
Lots of vines. Uh-huh. What are you standing on?
The bottom of the tree.
The bottom of the tree?
It's an old tree. It's got big roots.
Mm-hmm.
It's strong.
Mm-hmm. And do you feel that you're a male or female in that place?
A boy.
A boy. Mm-hmm. Look down at your feet. What do they look like?
Little white feet.
Little white feet, uh-huh. And can you tell what it is that you're wearing?
Raggedy pants.
Mm-hmm.
Raggedy shirt. Buttons.
Mm-hmm. So raggedy pants and shirt. Mm-hmm. You wearing anything in your on your head? Mm-hmm. Can you describe your features? What do you look like?
Dark hair.
Mm-hmm.
Cute little boy.
Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
7 or 8.
7 or 8. Mm-hmm.
Light skin.
Light skin. Mm-hmm.
Big eyes.
Mm-hmm.
Cute little boy.
So tell me what it is that you're doing in the forest. Do you have any shoes on? No.
I'm poor.
You're poor. Mm-hmm.
Maybe I'm running away from work.
Ah, you're running away from work. What is it that you're supposed to be doing?
I see a cart.
Mm-hmm. A cart?
A mule.
Mm-hmm. A cart with a mule?
I don't know, like, with, there's rocks inside the car. It's like a really rickety car. I'm supposed to be pulling it or getting it from one place to another. There's an old man.
There's an old man?
With a hat that's working with me.
Mm-hmm. What does he look like?
Old man of maybe 50, 60, gray,
mm-hmm.
with a beard all wrinkled from the sun.
And do you work with him?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is he any relations to you? Connect with him and see.
Uncle?
An uncle? That's how he feels to you? Mm-hmm. Tell me more. What are you supposed to be doing there?
Building a house of stone.
Mm-hmm.
Carrying the stones to go build the house.
Mm-hmm.
Out in the sun. But I want to go back to the trees, their shade.
Mm-hmm. You don't like being in the sun?
It's hard work.
It's hard work.
It's heavy.
You're a little boy. It must be hard.
I want to go to the trees when there's a nearby river.
Mm-hmm. So tell me what happens next. Where do you go?
I have to go back to help Uncle.
Mm-hmm. So go back to your uncle and see what happens next.
Put putting the stones as the foundation of the house we want to build.
Mm-hmm.
One of those houses that looks like just rocks, all hard, sturdy.
Mm-hmm. How big are these houses?
Not big.
Not big. Mm-hmm.
Just enough for a family. Just building it,
mm-hmm.
stone by stone.
Who else is helping?
Mm-hmm.
Just you and your uncle?
Mm-hmm. Another boy.
Mm-hmm. Let's see who he is.
With the hat.
He has a hat?
Yeah, like the kind of hat like my uncle has.
Mm-hmm. Is it a big hat?
No, it's like a farmer's hat.
A farmer's hat, okay.
He's wearing raggedy trousers and suspenders.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of reminds me of Huck Finn.
Mm-hmm.
Nice boy. Older.
What's his relation to you?
My brother, I think.
Mm-hmm. Connect with him and see. That's your brother.
Nice smile.
Mm-hmm. Do you like your brother?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Always making me laugh.
Mm-hmm.
Helping.
Does he take care of you?
I see a woman mm-hmm. next to a stove with the bun in her hair and kind of chubby and an apron.
Mm-hmm.
But she doesn't look nice. She has a grimace.
Mm-hmm. Connect with this woman and tell me who she is.
I see Aunt.
Mm-hmm. Is this your uncle's wife? What's
yes.
the relationship?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
She's grouchy. She's grouchy.
Tell me more about her.
She just has a grouchy look, and she's cooking something into the pan and the spatula.
Mm-hmm. Where is the stove?
In the kitchen.
So you're inside the house now?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about her?
It's just the way she is.
Mm-hmm.
She's not happy.
So let's find out more. Tell me more.
Me and my brother are sitting at the table. Eating food my aunt cooks.
Mm-hmm. What are you eating?
Some kind of meat, maybe from a goat.
Mm-hmm.
Gravy.
Gravy.
Water. There's glasses of water.
Mm-hmm.
But she's standing next to the stove cooking.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't want to sit down.
Who else is sitting with you?
My uncle.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Do you live with these people?
Yes.
Where are your parents?
I see coffins.
You see coffins.
Stone coffins.
Let's go back in time and see what happened to your parents. I want you to move back in time.
Baby.
Baby. You're a baby? Mm-hmm. And what's happening?
My big brother's near. poor.
You're not poor. Mm-hmm. Tell me more. Where are you?
At a party outside.
Mm-hmm. How are you dressed?
In a baby's gown.
Mm-hmm.
But we're not poor. It's nice.
Mm-hmm.
Outside party.
Who's there with you?
My mom.
Mm-hmm.
She's pretty, frilly, lacy dress.
Mm-hmm.
With a bonnet.
Who else is there?
Dad.
Mm-hmm. What does he look like?
He's stuffy, like he has spectacles and
mm-hmm.
a gold watch in his pocket with a chain attached,
mm-hmm.
and wearing a suit and vest, white starch shirt.
Mm-hmm.
Looks kind of stuffy.
Very stuffy. Uh-huh.
But okay.
What does your dad do for a living?
Banker, accountant, something mm-hmm. with numbers.
Something with numbers, uh-huh.
I see a pencil.
A pencil. And what does your home look like?
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty house, yellow. Flowers.
Mm-hmm.
Upstairs. Nice.
Mm-hmm.
Flowers on the balcony.
Beautiful. You're very happy. What do they call you?
Ignacio.
Ignacio? Mm-hmm. And what's your brother's name?
Eduardo.
Eduardo. Mm-hmm. Do you know where you live?
In that pretty house.
Mm-hmm. So Ignacio, I want you to go ahead to the point in your life where you lost your parents. Let's go there.
Oh.
What's happening?
Oh, they're in a ship. And there's a storm. And the ship turned over.
The ship turned over?
Yeah.
Do you know the name of the ship?
Castaic something.
Mm-hmm. Where were they going?
Not a big cruise ship, just a small ship.
Like a little ferry?
Like a wooden ship.
A wooden ship.
Primitive.
A primitive ship. And it turned over and they drowned?
Yeah.
Hmm. Where were you? Were you on the ship?
No.
No, but you know that happened.
Yeah.
So what happened next, Ignacio? Where did you go?
In a carriage. Somebody's, an old lady holding me in a carriage.
Mm-hmm. Who is this old lady?
My grandma, maybe?
Mm-hmm. Does she feel like a relative to you? Or did she take care of you?
No, she didn't take care of me. She's just taking me.
She's taking you. Mm-hmm. Is your brother with you too?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
The carriage. It's a nice carriage.
Mm-hmm. Is this your mother's mother? Your father's mother?
Mother's mother.
Mm-hmm.
She's dressed nice.
So let's see where she goes. Where do you go in that carriage?
To the town where I am
mm-hmm.
as a kid now.
Mm-hmm.
It's sunny, hot, dirt road, just dry.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about that?
has nothing. Doesn't have the nice house like we used to.
Mm-hmm.
So dry and barren and hot. But why? Why is she taking anything?
How do you feel about that?
Confused.
Mm-hmm. Did she tell you anything?
I'm a baby.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't talk.
I want you to connect with her mind. You can do that. Connect from mind to mind. And let's find out what she's thinking.
It's a shame. It's a shame these beautiful boys have to live here. I have to give them over to that. I have to give them over to that old couple, the woman with the mean face.
Why is that?
Nobody else.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody else to take care of the boys.
All right. So, Ignacio, I want you to close that scene and move ahead to another significant scene. You're older now. Be there now. What's happening?
In the house with Auntie.
Mm-hmm.
She's yelling at me.
Mm-hmm.
She's so mad.
Why is she mad? What's she saying?
I spilled something by accident.
Mm-hmm.
A cup of milk.
What does she do?
She's yelling at me. Pointing at me. Clumsy.
Mm-hmm. I want you to look at her eyes very closely. The eyes are the window to the soul.
I see my mom.
Mm-hmm.
It's my mom.
Okay.
She's so angry.
So let's move ahead now. Close that scene. Go to another significant event in their lifetime when something important is happening.
Why is my uncle on the... My uncle's dying.
Mm-hmm.
He's on the ground.
What
clutching
happened?
His heart.
Mm-hmm.
Clutching heart attack. On the ground.
What happened next?
Taking his last breath.
Are you with him?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing else to do. No one to call. He dies.
How are you feeling, Ignacio?
Empty.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Keep seeing my aunt's face mad.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens now that your uncle has died. Move ahead.
She's wearing black.
Mm-hmm.
She's in black. Next to the stove still.
Mm-hmm.
She's in black.
What does she look like? What does her outfit look like? Her dress.
Black linen.
Mm-hmm.
She's lost weight. Not that fat anymore.
Mm-hmm.
She wears black because of her dead husband.
Mm-hmm.
She's still angry.
Who's providing now for your family?
see my grandma again.
Mm-hmm. What is she doing there?
She's not there. She's just, I see my grandma in the carriage.
Mm-hmm. Did she come to visit?
Yes, she did.
Mm-hmm.
She's wearing black too. She's quiet.
Mm-hmm.
Curly gray, white hair, glasses.
Was your uncle her son?
No, she was.
No.
No, the aunt and uncle are from my dad's.
From your dad's side.
My mom was rich.
Mm-hmm.
Like my grandma.
So what happens now?
She sees how dirty the kitchen table is.
She's disapproving. How old are you, Ignacio, right now?
14.
Mm-hmm. What else does she see?
There's only one room in the house, and it's separated by a hanging blanket, raggedy quilt to mm-hmm. separate the bedroom.
Mm-hmm. Where do you sleep?
On the bed next to the raggedy curtain.
Mm-hmm.
Next to the window.
What happens with your grandmother?
She gets back into her carriage and drives off.
I leave you there.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder why she doesn't take care of us. She has money.
I want you to connect with her mind. Let's connect with her mind.
Hmm.
What is she thinking?
She thinks Casio, Eduardo, they're not my responsibility.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'll help them. They're not my responsibility. I'm not married, you know? I can't have them. I'm by myself. Have money, but I don't have a home for the boys. I'm better with the uncle and.
Mm-hmm. All right, Ignacio, close that scene and let's move ahead to another significant time. You're older now.
Mm-hmm.
Where are you?
At the river.
Mm-hmm.
The suspenders. I'm.
Oh. How old are you?
17.
Mm-hmm. What are you doing there?
There's a boat. There's like a river boat nearby.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice. Nice weather. So I want to get on the river boat. I want to jump on.
So what happens next?
I jump on,
mm-hmm.
going down the river.
Where do you go to?
Long river.
Mm-hmm.
See monkeys on the banks.
There's monkeys there?
On the banks of the river in the jungle.
Mm-hmm.
Hanging off trees. getting darker.
Mm-hmm. What happens next?
Trees. Curvy trees.
Dark people. Dark people.
Like Indians.
Mm-hmm. Have you seen these before?
They're savages.
Mm-hmm. Describe them for me.
No shirts, spears around the trees. Brown skin.
Mm-hmm.
They don't look nice.
Mm-hmm.
Spears. Young men.
Mm-hmm. Who are you with on this boat?
Ooh.
Are there other people?
Myself, but strangers.
Mm-hmm. So what happens as you go through this place?
I don't get off the boat.
Mm-hmm.
I just go down the river and keep on seeing those Indians.
How do they make you feel?
I don't want to go there with them. They're savages.
Mm-hmm. Do they scare you?
They're animals.
They're animals. Mm-hmm.
Jumping up and down, making noises with their spears. I don't want to be with them.
Mm-hmm.
Stay on the boat. It's nice on the boat. I don't have money, but do you let me stay on the boat?
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens next. What's the next significant event that's important?
I get off where I started from in the beginning again. I turned around. The boat turned around back home.
Mm-hmm.
Auntie's house. I'm a big woman now.
Mm-hmm.
Eating at the kitchen table. My brother's there too.
Mm-hmm.
We're both young men. He's got shorter hair than me, but we both have wavy brown hair.
Mm-hmm.
His is shorter. We're both young. Yeah. Feel good.
Good. So let's close that scene now. Close that scene, let's move forward to the next significant event when something is happening.
My auntie, she's... Something she ate.
Something she ate?
Poison or something bad made her sick.
She's sick now?
Falling on the floor. Clutching her throat, clutching her neck. Just collapsed.
She just collapsed. Mm-hmm. So what happens?
My brother and I just look at her. We pick her up, take her to the bed. She's on the bed.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't look angry anymore.
How does she look now?
Peaceful.
Peaceful.
She knows she's going up. She's peaceful now.
Mm-hmm. How are you feeling?
Fine.
Mm-hmm.
At least she's not angry anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Looking out the window.
How do you provide for yourself now?
Out the window, I see a man dressed in black, a priest,
mm-hmm.
coming with a black hat.
Has a black hat?
Black hat, glasses, mm. coming to, with holding a wooden cross, saying something above the bed of my dead aunt.
Mm-hmm. And then what?
Coffin. Coffin and a cross.
Mm-hmm.
Some flowers, coffin. My brother and I, free. Poor, free.
You're free now.
Yeah, we're young and poor, but free. No more empty.
So let's see where you go. What do you do from here?
I'm wearing a suit.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in a saloon or a casino.
Mm-hmm.
I'm wearing a suit.
What are you doing there?
Gambling. Got money in my hands.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of time.
Lots of money. Mm-hmm.
Uh-oh.
What happened?
Arguing with the dealer. Arguing with the dealer about the money.
What happened?
Oof. Gun.
Who has the gun?
Dealer?
Mm-hmm.
Who shoots me in the stomach against the wall.
So Ignacio, as you're there, what's happening?
Commotion.
Mm-hmm.
Running around, the cops come. Talking to the dead.
Mm-hmm. What about you?
Dead.
Mm-hmm.
Against the wall. Shot. Stomach. Blood.
So I'd like you to transition from that body. See yourself leaving that body. And tell me where it is that you go.
From my body, up, a ghost.
You're a ghost.
Up.
You're going up.
Up, spirit. Up to heaven.
Mm-hmm. So, Ignacio, as you're going up to heaven, I want you to look back at that life that you just lived. Every lifetime has purpose and lessons. What was the purpose of being born into that life?
I had to deal with my aunt.
Had to deal with your aunt? Mm-hmm. And what lessons did you learn while you were there?
She wasted being angry all the time.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't get peace until she died.
And what were you supposed to learn from that? What were your lessons?
Don't let her anger. Don't let her anger be contagious. was.
Mm-hmm. Was it then?
No.
Mm-hmm.
I was still happy.
Mm-hmm.
She didn't let her anger catch me.
Ignacia, did you have a soul contract with your auntie?
It's my mom.
Mm-hmm.
My mom.
So what would you like to tell Sue about that experience? How is it affecting her now?
Mom's angry.
Mm-hmm.
She tries to give me her anger.
Mm-hmm.
I don't want it.
So what would you like to tell Sue from your experience?
Don't let her anger affect you.
Okay. Wonderful.
She wants it to be contagious. But you can resist.
What should she do instead?
Love.
Love? Send her love?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. She, poor thing, she was angry all the time. Didn't enjoy anything.
Mm-hmm.
I feel sorry for her. She could have been happy. Grouchy all the time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, thank you very much, Ignacio. May the light of the universe accompany you. And now I want you to drift and float to another time and place. Another lifetime. We're drifting and floating. Floating and drifting to another time, another place. But there's information that will help you in the very best way. Where are you?
Indian.
Indian, tell me.
War paint.
A war paint.
And skin.
Mm-hmm.
A man with almost a mohawk, but shaved some parts. Hair in the middle,
mm-hmm.
but shaved the rest.
So he's wearing a mohawk?
Mm-hmm. Something like that.
Okay. Acclimate yourself into that body.
Am I him? Yeah, I guess I am.
Mm-hmm. How does it feel?
I'm angry.
Okay, tell me why.
Something happened to my little boy.
What happened to your little boy?
Killed him.
Who killed him?
White people.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
White settlers.
White settlers? How did they kill him?
He's in a little carriage? He's in a little box in a little carriage pulled by horses, and he dropped out.
Mm-hmm.
He fell off.
Mm-hmm. Who was pulling him?
Some white family.
Why did they have him?
His mother gave the baby to the white people to take care of. She couldn't take care of it.
Mm-hmm.
She's poor.
Mm-hmm.
But he fell off the wagon.
So why are you angry?
That was my boy.
Mm-hmm. Why did the mother give him away? Why couldn't you hold on to him?
fight with my wife.
You fought with your wife? Mm-hmm.
And now I have bow and arrow to shoot white people.
All right. So let's see what happens next. Tell me where you are.
In the town near the saloon.
Mm-hmm.
I'm wearing a suit. I still look Indian.
Mm-hmm.
I'm wearing a suit outside the saloon. They won't let me in.
They won't let you in? Why is that?
I'm not white.
Mm-hmm.
They tell me to stand. Angry. I want to go in and drink.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
I sit outside the saloon. Can't go in. Mad.
You're mad? Mm-hmm. What do they call you?
Tehak.
Tehak. Tehak, how old are you?
22.
22. Mm-hmm.
I'm sitting outside the saloon. My hands together trying to figure out how to get in there.
Mm-hmm. Is there no reason to go in to drink or to do something else?
Saloon girls.
Ah, you like the saloon girls? Mm-hmm.
They smell good. Pretty dress. Pretty girl.
So what happens next, Tehak? Go to the next significant scene.
Saloon girl comes out. Night. I take her.
Where do you take her?
I force her.
You force her?
I rip off her clothes. Oof. Someone sees me doing it.
Oof. What happened?
They shoot me.
Where do they shoot you?
In the groin.
Mm-hmm.
Oof.
You don't have to feel it. You can just observe it now.
Oish.
Go outside your body and just observe what happens.
Shh. Girl gets away. Mm-hmm. I'm on the floor. I'm on the ground. Clutching my groin.
Mm-hmm.
Oish. Oish. The white men are saying, Sutu. Served you right, trying to be the white.
Mm-hmm.
Oof, they leave me there on the floor, on the ground, writhing. Just leave me there, just on the floor, all doubled over.
And what happens to you, Tehak?
You die. Float up.
Mm-hmm. So as you float up and look at that life from behind.
Anger.
Yeah, lots of anger there. Where do you go?
Float up.
Are you able to get to the light or do you stay here? Where do you go?
Heaven.
Mm-hmm.
White.
All white. So what lessons did you learn?
Anger.
You learned about anger?
Mm-hmm.
What about anger?
Not worth it.
Not worth it. It got you into trouble. What were you supposed to be learning in that lifetime? painting art. You were supposed to be painting?
Colors.
Mm-hmm.
I was good at it.
And what happened?
Anger, fighting.
You got in the way of your mission here?
Mm-hmm.
So I'd like you to tell me how your anger is affecting Sue in this lifetime.
She gets pissed off fast.
Mm-hmm.
Principal pissed her off.
Mm-hmm.
Said she was being rude.
Mm-hmm.
Told her supervisor to scold her. Who got mad?
Mm-hmm. Tehak, did you actually go to heaven or did you attach to this woman?
I'm with her.
Mm-hmm. You never did go to heaven, did you?
I'm with her.
You're with her. How did you connect with her?
She was a little girl. Mm-hmm. All sad, crying.
Mm-hmm.
Because of Mama. He comforted her when she was a little girl.
Mm-hmm.
And she was crying.
So, Tehak, tell me, how did you find her?
I saw her crying.
Mm-hmm.
After her mom was mean.
Mm-hmm.
Comforted her.
Did she call you? Did she ask for you to come to her?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Did she know you from another life? Did you have a contract with her?
Yes, she...
Where did you know her from before?
Greece?
Greece? Mm-hmm. Who were you?
I was the old man at the Hall of Records.
Mm-hmm.
And she was gifted in writing.
Mm-hmm. Were you in love with her?
Oh, no. He was an old man.
Oh, he was an old man.
Sue was a young man.
Mm-hmm.
With his own wife and kids. Oh, Lydia. Blonde.
So what were you in that Hall of Records with her? What was the contract there?
We're both gifted in writing.
Mm-hmm.
We belonged. But Sue went to war, got killed.
Mm-hmm.
I'm an old angry man.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm head of the Hall of Records.
Mm-hmm.
I'm angry.
Did you attach to Sue in that lifetime for any particular reason?
Young. New, young, gifted.
Mm-hmm. So you just
I'm old.
You wanted to continue your life in that young body?
I like him because he's young.
Mm-hmm.
Young, smart, has a beautiful woman.
Mm-hmm. So did you follow the soul throughout lifetimes?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So how is it that you're affecting the life of Sue now?
Anger.
Do you think that's fair? That she has to carry this anger that's not hers?
But Marvin, the principal, made her angry.
Mm-hmm. But throughout life, people do get you. Do say things to you. Mm-hmm.
A lot.
Yes. But you don't have to get angry. How are you affecting her otherwise? What else do you do to her to affect her?
Melody.
Mm-hmm. How do you affect her with melody?
Make melody, practice piano.
Mm-hmm.
make Melody clean her room.
Mm-hmm. And you don't think that Sue, as a mother, can do that on her own? Seems to me like you're not giving her any credit.
But the room has to be clean.
Mm-hmm.
She has to practice piano.
And what responsibility is it of you, Teja, to do that? This is the responsibility of Sue as a mother, not of you, of your own accord. Why do you interfere with her life?
She needs me.
She needs you.
I comfort her.
Mm-hmm. Shouldn't she be comforted with her loved ones?
But her mom was awful.
Mm-hmm.
What about her? I comforted her.
What about her husband?
He's nice.
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
Tehak, where is it that you're attached to her? What part of her body?
Stomach.
The stomach. Is she feeling any symptoms in her stomach?
She's got a big tummy.
Big tummy, is that you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that's right for you to be housed in that stomach all that time?
Guess not.
Mm-hmm. What else are you causing?
Her neck.
Mm-hmm. What's happening with her neck?
Neck pain.
Mm-hmm.
Shoulders.
Mm-hmm. She's carrying quite a load with you.
I guess.
Mm-hmm. Is that birthmark that she has? Is that yours?
Yes.
Why did you give her that birthmark?
It hurt so much.
Mm-hmm.
When they shot me.
Mm-hmm. But it was in her body. What was your body?
I guess.
Mm-hmm. Did you secretly want to be found out, Dad?
Found out?
Mm-hmm, that you were there.
With the girl?
Did you want to be found out in her body, in Sue's body? Mm-hmm.
I'm angry.
I know. Tehak, when a body dies, the soul should transition. It has its own evolution into the light. That's home. This light is part of the light of Source.
Boring.
Have you been there before?
Boring.
Mm-hmm. But you have to get your own body, Tehak, not take over somebody else's body. And you violated the free will of this woman. Do you think that's fair?
No.
No. And you've given her all of these symptoms? All of this anger that doesn't belong to her? A big tummy?
Mm.
Neck pain? Shoulder pains? Do you think that's right?
Mm.
She should be able to live her own life. Don't you think? And you progress on your own?
Mm.
What would you like to tell Sue about that now?
Sorry.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to touch Sue's forehead so that I could speak with her now. Sue, have you been listening? You see that all of these symptoms belong to an angry young man? Can you forgive this man for
mm-hmm.
doing this?
Mm-hmm.
Are you ready to let him go so that you can live your life without all that anger? You have to be willing to let him go.
He comforted me.
He did when you were little. But now all he does is make you angry and not, it doesn't allow you to work out things that keep coming back over and over again. Any situation that gets you angry, you can't deal with it because Tehak has been influencing you. Wouldn't it be nice to have a clean slate where it's really you and not someone influencing you? Okay, let me speak with Tehak again. Tehak, are you ready to go into the light now? I'm going to ask my angels to come and comfort you. I'm going to ask them to surround you. And I want you to feel what it feels like to have love from Source.
Mm.
How does that feel?
My angels are nice around me.
Mm-hmm. Wouldn't you want to feel more of that?
Yeah.
Doesn't that feel good? It's not very boring, is it? Feels good. All right, before you leave, Tehuk, I want you to go feeling light as a feather. But you have a lot of baggage with you. Would you like me to help you unload all of that? Very good. So what I'm going to do, Tehuk, is I'm going to put my hand on your chest. And I want you to give me all of that anger that you had, all of those feelings of not being given a life that you wanted to, having lost your baby, not being accepted for your race, not getting what you wanted, and having to follow this poor woman lifetime through lifetime. Give that all to me. I'm going to give it to the universe for healing. And tell me when I have it all.
You have it.
All right, let me take that, and I'm going to send it to the universe, to the light. And now, Tehuk, in that space that's left there, so vacant, I want you to tell me what would you like to put. Let's put lots of love in there. Lots of love. Big fire hose.
Forgiveness.
Mm-hmm. And forgiveness. Let's put all that forgiveness in there. Mm-hmm. What else? How do you feel? You want anything else?
Creativity?
Lots more creativity. You're already creative, but let's give you even more.
Talented.
Mm-hmm. Yes. How does that make you feel?
Good.
Good. Are you ready to let go now? I want you to do one more thing for me to have before you leave. I want you to go from all the way from her toes to the head, and I want you to pull out from her by the roots all of your influence. Pull all those cords and cables, everything that was attached to her, everything that kept you connected with her.
Okay.
What does it look like?
It's just a bundle of ropes.
Mm-hmm.
Tethers and all colors.
All right, pull them all out. Pull them all out. Grab them all.
Yeah.
You're going to take it with you. And now I'm asking the angels of the light to accompany. I want you to go out through the crown of her head right here. Go out.
With the angels.
Beautiful. And tell me when you get to the light of source.
Okay, I'm there.
Beautiful. Tehuk, may the light of the universe accompany you. Thank you very much for helping this woman today.
Okay.
Thank you very much. I want you to go back in time now. We're going to go back in time. And we're going to erase all of those bad feelings that you felt. I want you to see yourself going back very quickly. See yourself getting smaller and smaller and smaller until you're a baby. Mm-hmm. And now we want to change the reaction that you had towards your mom and she had towards you. And I want to see you fast forwarding through that life. See yourself fast forwarding and see the scenes differently.
She was frustrated.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Took it out of me.
Mm-hmm.
He was messing around.
Mm-hmm.
Took it out on me.
So can you forgive her now for that?
That's me.
Mm-hmm. You're not forgiving the act. Forgiveness doesn't mean that you condone what she did, that you agreed with what she did. Forgiving means that you yourself don't need to suffer with this anymore. It's like when you eat some fish and you get a bone stuck in your gum. Are you going to blame the person who gave you the fish for the rest of your life?
No.
You take the bone out and stop complaining about the pain. So forgiveness is like this. You take the bone out and you move on.
Okay.
So now as you look at your life, and you can forward through your life, can you see that you don't need to take that pain? You don't need to take her words and her actions and make them yours.
Right.
Can you forgive yourself for holding this bone
I didn't know any better.
You didn't know any better, of course. And that's what forgiveness is all about. It's understanding that you didn't know any better. And she didn't either. She was overwhelmed with so many children and the frustration of her husband. She just didn't know any better.
That was the tension.
Mm-hmm. So I want you now to go back in time and let's see where it was that you made that contract with her. I want you to go back the time before you were born. And let's see when you made that contract to be the punching bag. Be there now.
Oh. Oh, she's one of the guys that shot me.
Mm-hmm.
In the groin.
Okay.
She's the cowboy with the mustache.
She's the cowboy with the mustache.
Mm-hmm. The gun, laughing.
Mm-hmm.
Laughing at me. I'm writhing on the floor in pain, laughing at me.
Mm-hmm. And who was this woman to this cowboy that you were attacking?
My mom was the cowboy that, mm-hmm. that shot me in the groin after he found me with that white woman.
Mm-hmm. And was there any relationship with that white woman and him?
Oh.
Who was she?
My dad.
Mm-hmm.
Oish. My dad was the saloon.
Mm-hmm.
I tried to get with her. But the cowboy stopped me.
So tell me the story. What's the reason why she treated you badly in this lifetime?
The cowboy?
Mm-hmm. Why did your mom, why did the cowboy decide to come back as your mom? She wasn't done with you, was she?
It's not.
Mm-hmm. Can you forgive her now, knowing that you were taking advantage?
Yeah, I was trying to take advantage.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'm so angry.
So I want you to see your mom and that cowboy, which is one and the same, in front of you. And we're going to break the contract now. We're going to stop this. So I want you to see them in front of you with the contracts that you both have into this lifetime and any other lifetimes that's affecting you. And I want you to say to them, we tried, we'd really tried. It's not working. You go your way with love. And I'll go my way. We don't need to be connected anymore. So I want you to see yourself tearing up that contract and they tear up theirs.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So we don't need to have this vengeance going through lifetime to lifetime.
Yeah, it was a long time ago.
And this will affect every other lifetime that you're living, forwards and backwards. How do you feel now?
Torn up, the contract's torn up.
Mm-hmm. How does it feel in your being?
You don't need the anger.
You don't need the anger. It wasn't yours anyway. You had a lot of soup in there. A lot of different things going on. So we can go on now for this day, from this day forward, without needing to have that anger anymore. We don't need that vengeance anymore in this lifetime or another lifetime. We now understand that this was just something that came from a situation that shouldn't have happened.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So now that we have that, let me connect now with your higher self so that I can get answers to your questions. May I speak with Sue's higher self, please? Thank you. Thank you for allowing me to put that puzzle piece together. What else did you want to tell her about these lives that she just saw?
That's why she likes Westerns.
Mm-hmm.
That time.
She was a cowboy, huh? An Indian.
West.
Mm-hmm. Anything else that, from that lifetime that you wanted to show her?
Oh, I wasted my time, I think.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't need to be so angry.
Yeah. What about the lifetime of the little boy? Why did you show her that lifetime?
Because that mom, that aunt was so angry, I saw,
mm-hmm.
saw the waste. But I didn't let it affect me.
Right.
That's just right. Just the way she is.
That's right.
Poor thing.
Where was this lifetime?
In Mexico.
In Mexico.
New Mexico.
In New Mexico?
New Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Very good.
Could that you was white.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I was an Indian.
She has questions about her gift in music and songwriting and wants to know what she should do about that.
Oh, she should teach her little girl.
Mm-hmm.
That's what she should do. Sing with her little girl.
Is that why she should? Is there anything that she should be doing for anyone else besides her little girl?
Teaching disabled kids.
Mm-hmm. Music. Okay,
teaching good. Piano to disabled kids.
Very good, very good. What about her writing skills? She's writing that book about old Shanghai.
Yeah.
Is that her purpose in this life?
No.
Okay, so what, tell me about that book. Why is she writing?
Aunt Jingshu.
Mm-hmm.
Find Aunt Jingshu.
Find Aunt Jingshu and
connect
with her. What guides?
She still has family.
Yes, she does.
I'm her family.
Mm-hmm.
She isn't forgotten. She thinks everybody has forgotten about her.
Mm-hmm.
It's not true. Sue still cares.
So how can we connect with Jingshu? How can she find her if she doesn't speak Chinese?
Translators.
So do you recommend that she go to China to find her aunt?
Yes, she should.
Okay.
She should. Scott wants to go to China, take the little one too.
Yes, and that would be a good way to introduce
her
to the family.
Yeah, we could go next summer.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful.
Find Aunt Jingshu.
Perfect.
She would love Melody.
Mm-hmm. What about her writing the book? Should she wait until she finds Jingshu to finish?
Yes.
Okay, good. She knows a lot of language.
The book's not important. It's Jingshu.
It's Jingshu. That was just her bridge to it?
Yeah.
Okay, good. She has a lot of language skills, speaking lots of language.
Yeah.
What does she need to do with that?
Melody.
Should she teach Melody all of these languages?
Mm-hmm.
Is that where Melody came to her?
Nazi.
You're a Nazi.
Okay. Nazi soldier, big helmet,
mm-hmm.
big cloak.
Melody was a Nazi tramp?
Yes.
Okay. Tell me more about that.
Tanks. Big tanks coming into Poland.
Into Poland? Mm-hmm.
Jews.
Was Sue in that lifetime?
Yes.
What was Sue in that lifetime?
A Jew.
A Jew. Tell me more about this.
Melody found the Jews hiding.
Mm-hmm.
Shot the whole family.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Melody.
Is that why Melody, when she was a baby, said Achtung?
Yes.
What was she trying to say to her?
The tanks. Don't let the tanks run you over.
So Melody was reliving that?
I guess so.
Mm-hmm. Why did she choose this family to be born into?
With bombing?
Mm-hmm. Why would a Nazi soldier choose a Jew from another lifetime to be her mother?
Guilt.
Mm.
Guilt. I killed her.
Mm-hmm.
I killed the whole family. I didn't need to kill them. I could have taken them to the camps.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't need to kill them right away. There were little ones. There were little ones in the family too. I killed all of them with my gun.
Is there anything that is affecting Melody from that lifetime that needs to be cleared today? That may affect her in the future?
Don't know what, she doesn't know what to do with all her energy.
Mm-hmm.
Always jumping around. She might be destructive with her energy.
Mm-hmm. What can we do today to help her with that?
Get her into activities.
Mm-hmm.
She uses the energy well.
Good.
Positive energy.
So as her mom, she needs to get her into programs where she's using that energy.
Use the energy wisely. Sports.
Oh, sports. Very good. Very good. So now we have that behind us. She has recurring dreams of Germany, of being a foreigner.
The tanks coming into Poland.
Mm-hmm. What were the dreams trying to tell her? Or was she reliving that?
Tanks coming into Poland.
Okay.
People running around all over,
mm-hmm.
getting away from the tanks.
That was real. It wasn't a dream.
Nazis shooting at us.
Mm-hmm.
Big guns.
Big guns. What about the dreams of falling off of stairs or cliffs? Where is that coming from?
Pushed off the stairs.
Mm-hmm. Who did that?
Oh. Nazi pushed me off. Oish.
Tell me.
Oh. Melody. Melody pushed a woman. Melody pushed a woman from the top of the stairs all the way down.
Mm-hmm.
Oish. Melody.
What was Melody's name in that life?
Jürgen.
Mm-hmm. Jürgen. And what was
Vicious.
His? Vicious. Mm-hmm.
Brute.
And what was his name in that life?
Helena.
Helena?
Helena.
Helena. Okay. Do you want to tell me anything more about that lifetime? Okay.
Melody shot my family.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me what the dreams were about where she was bound and gagged?
Raped.
And raped? What was that about?
She was a woman that was raped.
Mm-hmm.
Gagged, bound.
What lifetime was that?
Hungary.
In Hungary. What year was that?
1683.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything that you need to do about that lifetime? Why is it coming up?
My mom.
That was her mom?
My mom did it.
Okay. So her mom has been following her from lifetime to lifetime, torturing her?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. We broke the contract today. What are the dreams about her teeth falling out?
So it continues to happen.
Beggar.
A beggar.
Old beggar.
Mm-hmm.
On the streets.
What year was that?
China.
In China.
China.
1700s.
Old beggar.
Mm-hmm.
Streets.
Why is she dreaming about that? What does she need to know about that?
Take care of her teeth.
Take care of her teeth. Is she doing it?
Not good.
Okay. Good. Very good. How can she honor her ancestors even more?
Jingshu.
Jingshu. Okay, perfect. Can you tell me what her specialty?
Only Jingshu.
Only Jingshu?
Go meet Jingshu.
Okay, good. What's her fascination with Egypt all about?
I was in Egypt.
Tell me more.
Pyramids.
Mm-hmm.
I was a worker.
A worker.
Building pyramids.
Mm-hmm.
Hot sun. I need water.
Mm-hmm. How did you die in that lifetime?
Rock fell on me.
Mm. How is that affecting Sue now?
Tummy.
In the tummy.
Fell on my tummy.
Okay. Can the higher self please work on the tummy to eliminate that karma?
If she stops picking out.
Mm-hmm. Can you help with those cravings?
Yeah.
Thank you. I'd like you to rewire her so that when she sees something that she's not supposed to eat.
Cake.
Mm-hmm.
Whipped cream.
Mm-hmm.
No, you don't need it. You don't need it.
Okay.
You don't need it. No.
Good. Rewire her so that she doesn't have those cravings anymore. She'll be able to think of healthy foods. Thank you. Would you tell me about her mother-in-law, Betty?
Betty.
Mm-hmm.
Smiling. Smiling over Melody.
Has Betty gone to the light, back to source?
Nope.
Nope.
She's with us.
What's holding her here?
She loves Scotty.
Mm-hmm.
Scotty's her boy.
Is Betty influencing Scotty?
Yes.
And in what way?
Decisions.
Mm-hmm.
Can't make up his own mind.
Mm-hmm.
She's telling him what to do.
Mm-hmm. Would you permit me to connect with Betty today?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I'm going to count from 3 down to 1. When I get to 1, let me speak with Betty. I'll touch your forehead. 3, 2, and 1. Good afternoon, Betty.
Hi.
Hi. How have you been?
Oh, good. Melody's so cute.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my little girl.
Cute granddaughter.
Adorable.
Mm-hmm. Betty, tell me what you do during the day with your family.
Wait for them to come home from work, school. Mm-hmm. I'm in the kitchen.
Mm-hmm. Do they notice that you're there?
Not really.
Mm-hmm. I understand that they built a nice shrine for you.
Yeah, Sue did.
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about that?
It's good.
Good? You like seeing your picture there?
Yeah, I got my little stuffed animals.
Mm-hmm. All the things that you love.
My rosary.
Mm-hmm. It's like not being gone at all, is it?
No, I'm with my little boy, Scotty.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, good little boy.
Melody, do you realize that all spirits, once they transition out of a body, should go back home to the light? Did you know that?
I'm fine where I am.
I know you're fine, but you no longer have a body. And once you transition, there's a certain thing that you need to do. It's like graduation. Graduation from school. What you should have done is gone to the light, and there, in that light, you'll be able to go back to school, you'll be able to rest for a while, be able to learn things, and you'll be able to help others from that light in a much better way, in a much more advanced way. Right now, you're just a soul without a body.
I'm with Scotty.
You'll be with Scotty also. But you'll be in a different form. You'll be in a different place.
Would you like to feel what this light feels like so that you understand? Because you'll never know unless you feel it, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to ask my angels of the light to come and surround you, Betty, so that you can feel their love.
Mm.
Tell me when they're there.
Yeah.
Tell me what you feel from them.
Oh, pretty angels fluttering around me.
Mm-hmm. What are they telling you?
Love.
Love. Mm-hmm.
Independence.
Yes. What else?
My Scotty needs it.
Mm-hmm. Betty, I want you to go up to the light and just experience what you feel from that light and tell me if there's anybody there that's waiting for you.
My son.
Mm-hmm.
He died. He was in Vietnam, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Soldier.
And he's there waiting for you.
Yeah.
You forgot about that son, didn't
you? And his uniform.
Isn't that beautiful?
Oh.
Didn't you want to be with that son too for a while? Okay.
Danny.
But before you leave, Betty, I want you to say goodbye. Sue's loved you very much. She's built that shrine for you. She wanted you to stay with her. What would you like to tell her now?
You're taking good care of my son. He's in good hands with you. You're a beautiful little girl.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to tell your son? What would you like to tell Scotty?
You need to grow up. You need to grow up. You're not a little boy anymore. Stand up for yourself.
And I'm going to touch your forehead and see what would you like to tell Betty?
Betty, I'm going to take good care of Scott, just like you did. He needs to grow up. I'll help
him. Mm-hmm. Ask her if you need to have that shrine for her anymore. Let me know what Betty says.
I want that shrine. Sue wants that shrine for respect.
Mm-hmm.
You have to respect your elders in
Good.
China.
Wonderful.
Respect.
So she'll have that shrine there for respect, but you'll be able to be in the light instead of there physically. Very good, Betty. Betty,
I'm
go.
I'm going to be with Danny.
That's beautiful, isn't it? He needs you more than ever. Mm-hmm. So I want you to say goodbye to Sue, and I want you to go off through the crown of her head, right through here. And I want all of the angels to surround you and take you up to the light and tell me when you're there, Betty.
Yeah.
Thank you. May the light of the universe accompany you. Lots of love and peace for you. Thank you for being here today. Let me speak with Sue's higher self again.
Mm-hmm.
I have a question about who Davi is.
Davi.
Davi. Mm-hmm.
Davi. Oh, Davi. Oh.
Who was he?
He's a little boy.
He's a little boy? Mm-hmm. Did she know him in a different lifetime?
Oh.
Tell me.
He was his friend.
Mm-hmm.
He was Tehak's friend.
Ah.
Oh, Davi wasn't white, he was Chinese.
Mm-hmm.
We were both kept out of the saloon.
Ah.
We had to sit outside.
Mm-hmm. So there were two of you.
Me and a Chinese.
Mm-hmm. And why does Sue have dreams about Davi? Was Davi trying to tell her something? Did he just come into her life?
to say hi? Tell me.
David Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell me about that? What is it that you're seeing? Who is Debbie?
It's
Debbie is the Chinaman that was my friend.
Mm-hmm.
He was mad too.
So that was Tehok's friend? Okay.
He was mad too, like me.
Mm-hmm.
We drank together.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Very good. Is there anything that I should have asked that I have not asked today?
Rash.
The rash, okay.
Rash on her chest.
Okay, can you do an entire body scan and see if there's anything else? Okay, tell me about the rash.
On her chest.
Mm-hmm.
Above her left breast.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. They shot her in the chest too, the cowboys.
Mm-hmm.
Weesh. Blood everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Good shot.
Mm-hmm.
Ignacio. Shot in the stomach.
Mm-hmm.
Chest. Oh, guns. Too many guns.
So would you tell me, as her sire self, Ignacio and Tehak, were they past lives or were they influences on her? I know that from a higher self perspective, everyone is one. But in her case,
just immature. You need to be more mature, Ignacio. Fighting over money. Ugh. What did that get you? It got you shot in the tummy.
Mm-hmm.
You were still young. Tehok always angry.
Mm-hmm. So can you tell the difference of her higher self, whether they were past lives or influences?
Past lives.
Past lives. Very good. Welcome back. How do you feel? Were they one with your hands?
Mm-hmm.
How does they feel?
Good.
Good? You've had a wonderful experience.
Oof.
What do you feel was the most important that you learned from this?
The edging shoe.
Yes, go find her.
Find her, tell her she hasn't been forgotten, abandoned.
Mm-hmm. Take your husband and daughter.
Yeah.
And what about the part where your daughter?
Eesh, she was a Nazi.
Yeah.
She needs to work off that karma.
And you need to love her and forgive her.
I do.
Mm-hmm.
I do.
Yeah.
But I'm afraid, like, she might be destructive. She might use her energy.
But that's why she found you. So now that you know about this, you send her love. Because that's what she needs. She needs to be forgiven for that.
Yeah.
She knew that she didn't do the right thing.
Yeah.
And that you will forgive her. You'll love her unconditionally. Yeah. She needed to come back to you so that you, as a mother, will love her unconditionally.
I do.
Okay. And how long do you feel that you were on this journey? How did it feel?
30 minutes.
an hour and a half and counting.
Okay.
So with the induction, probably about an hour and 45, almost 2 hours. Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
How do you feel physically?
Fine.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't feel my whole body. It was like almost like, you know, when you first wake up from sleep and then you mm-hmm. finally find your...
Yes, the bearings. Yeah.
Yeah. When I was under, I felt like I was asleep. Like, I didn't feel
cool.
any part of my body.
Well, you are very, very... you really see this stuff vividly.
I did.
How does this compare to other hypnosis sessions that you've had?
The other ones... This one was more vivid.
Mm-hmm. Had more information.
Yeah, and I felt... Like when I determined it was my dad that I was trying to rape,
mm-hmm.
or when I determined it was Melody who was the Nazi that killed me, I felt the emotion.
Mm-hmm. And you were able to let it go.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Good. You recommend this to other people?
Of course.
Experience? Good.
Of course.
Is this something you want to share? You want to keep private?
I want to. You know how you white out the faces sometimes?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. I mean, I'm okay with the story and my voice, but just my face.
Sure.
White it out.
Get a little... That's fine. That's fine with me. It was very interesting, especially, you know, there was a lot of confusion whether the Indian was actually your past life or was an actual attachment. There was a lot of confusion there because he had gone... through different lifetimes with you, and the anger was there. Mm-hmm. So there's a little.
Yeah, there's anger.
Yeah.
There's anger. I'm always.
Mm-hmm.
My sisters tell me that. My friends tell me that. They're mm-hmm. like, sometimes we're afraid to tell you stuff or do stuff mm-hmm. because we're afraid you're gonna get pissed off.
Yeah, but we did a lot of healing there, where we yeah. were able to let that go. And when you actually go into a lifetime and heal it, it affects every lifetime that you're living, backwards and forwards. So I thought we did a lot of healing work there. You
it
know?
Was very vivid.
Yeah, because every time I asked your higher self, it's like, no, you're going back into the vision of it again.
sometimes even before you finished asking me a question, the answer came really fast.
Yeah, well, that's because we were connected. I mean, that's the whole thing of... Yeah. Of when we're doing this, I put myself into a trance and connect with you.
Mm-hmm.
And so kind of like my thoughts are, you're already hearing what I'm
yeah.
getting my gist already.
Yeah.
Terrific. Let me unbuckle you. Let me get you going. Mm-hmm.